There we go. Back. Perfect. All right.
Hey, tunes, crank the tunes up so you guys don't have to listen to just soft. A little blues music. A little YouTube friendly music.
References. Okay, here we go. Nice, real nice. That was sweet. Sorry about that. I broke my tripod. So, let's get back at it. That was awesome. Make sure you give this a like. All right, let's go. Now. I've been waiting for you. I've been waiting for you. Okay. Yeah, that was crazy shit right there. Yes, somebody else has done to destroy my life. Okay, back at it. God damn, I love this song. Time to recharge. Repeat. Civilian. Yeah, perfect. Okay.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Laura. Actually, I'm gonna drop that down a bit. Let's see.
Thank you.
about that, everybody. We'll be right back.
Yeah. everybody.
Good session. Good session. Let me turn the chat on. Live chat. I'm from Poland. What's up? Sorry. That's okay. The chainsaw speaks. What's up? What's up, Elvis? What's up, Glenn? What's up, Spike? How's everybody doing today? Good day today. 62 people. Whoa, cool. Sweet.
I forgot to do hashtag stuff, too. Oh, I don't know if you guys can hear the tunes or not, but I thought it'd be a nice addition. Music YouTube friendly. Music, so I don't get monetized and credit, whatever it is. So, lady, the feather pattern, pretty much almost got it. And
once I get the feather pattern, then we'll move up. Thanks, Rob. And then we'll gotta get the twist in that neck really working good.
And once you put the black on, it'll pop.
Okay, we're coming back in, guys.
Guys and girls and gang members.
Just gonna look at something and then I'll switch my camera around. Ah. What's up? What's up, everybody? Just trying to get a couple things organized, make sure everything's working good. I want one of those ravens. Nice, thanks. Okay, so. Let's get back at it, you know? I'm on fire right now, I'm feeling good. This is moving fast, I need my blower, that's what I stopped for. Obviously, I don't know if you guys can hear the music, but I'm trying to put some stuff on today. But I'm not listening to the same thing you are. Because that would be crazy to be jamming that hard to blues. High line, certain disgust, blah, blah, blah. Oh. No, 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 whoa, whoa, whoa. Cancel. Okay. We're still good? Still good? Alright, cool. Alright, here we go.
Back at it.
Rock it out. Phew! 67!
Right out. What up?
St. Thomas. It's because I'm sponsored by them. Yeah!
They're awesome.
Yeah. Nice. What's up, everybody? I'll take a couple questions because I see some people want some stuff. I hope everyone's being nice and not talking shit. Tools for tools. I'm using Echo. I saw somebody commented that they were wondering why I was using... who am I listening to right now? I'm listening to this song called 16. It's like 16 years to find ya, 1 second to love ya. It's a crazy love song. It's wicked. And then I'm listening to Kim Dark and Silver Sun Pickups and Banks and Steels. And I'm just ripping. Did you go to at school, Ryan? No, I just carved. I take classes with some clay guys, and I've done some human form sculpture classes with some guys. But he's no longer doing them. He booked this like insane gig. His name's Saban Howard. And my clay guy is named Spider Zero. That's Simon Lee. But for my class, I'm doing classes for carving for beginning to intermediates right now. The next class will be in, thank you, Lori. The next class will be in March, and it's Zoom. And, thanks, Luann, that's sweet. Yeah, I have Echo Blower. I have Echo everything. As far as power tools go, Makita's my sponsor for tools. I use Canon bars for everything else. So if anybody's like looking to start carving, want to know the tools, you want to get yourself like an all-around saw, I would say you're looking at like an Echo 501P with a 12-inch Canon dime tip bar. But the 12-inch Canon dime tip bar is the best bar for a beginner carver to learn the all-around skills. As you have seen today, I'm not using them. I kind of have like a lot of different saws, so I use that bar, but I'm actually really lazy because I blew my 12-inch, the saw that has the 12-inch dime tip bar up last week, and I'm too lazy to swap it over. So I have it on a 361P, but I haven't got that. I'm using my 2511, which is the small bar I just was using for detail. But I really did like the, yeah, I can see your messages, whoever that was. What else? Yeah, so that's about it. I gotta get this thing done. It's shaping out nice. If you guys were watching at the beginning, the beak broke and I lost about 4 inches of it. So that sucked. But yeah, Brian, I see you too. What's the model of the Echo Blower? Oh man, I don't know.
It's this one.
Oh, there's the name. PB250LN. So I like it. It works good. I like this a lot of the time for when I'm doing like my quick stuff. So yeah, I mean, pitter patter, let's get at her. Right now I'm kind of finishing up the finalizing with the chainsaw. So yeah, thanks for everybody who's watching my page too. I wouldn't be here without you guys. I really am enjoying inspiring anybody that can carve. I know that there is, this is just a Makita battery blower. I don't know what the brand is, man. I just Google it. I am really enjoying it. I appreciate all the support I get from all you guys. It's very encouraging, and I keep the videos coming. I got some wicked ones coming up. This one, that's why I'm rushing. So this log right here is 8 feet, 5 feet wide. And I'm gonna start that tomorrow or today by at least templating it. And it's gonna be eagle wings up, landing on a perch tree with fish in it, with a mama bear about 5 feet tall and a cub about 2 feet tall and a fish swimming underneath. So that should be video montage style out for like Christmas Day if I can get everything to go good. Yeah, it's big log, about 5 feet at the butt, or 56 inches at the butt. And what else? Yeah, I've got the Bigfoot, or the woolly Yeti dude that's right over here. He'll be out tomorrow, as most, well, if you can tell, his arm's a bit long, and it's bothering me. So before I do that, I want to, or finish the video, I want to fix it and retake some pictures. And then once I get that done, then I'll have that video up, and then I'm gonna have a joinery video coming out. How does the class work? So the class works like this. What we're finding the best is it's 12 of us. We get together at 4:30 p.m. today on Tuesdays, and I assign everybody a task for the week. We have a private group. I'm not gonna tell it because I'm getting a lot of requests for it, but it's not public, but I mean, whatever, if you find it, you know, it's for classmates. It's for the Saw Valley class. So we post, I kind of critique a little bit. I'm trying to be more encouraging than critiquing. I'll say something if they ask a specific question, but during the class, it's like a 2-3 hour Zoom lesson. It's slated for 2 hours. It's been going for 3 hours every class. And I just, anyone has a question, they ask it. Anyone has a carving, a request, I'll talk about it, and then I'll talk a little bit at the beginning about what they did, what I think they can improve on, and then I'll carve as much as I can of that week's assignment. So the first week we did was a tree and a bear, and then it was awesome. Everybody did so good. And then the second week we're doing, this week we did eagles, and then today we're doing, we're gonna do spirit faces. And then next week it's carver's choice, because I won't be there. I won't be able to assign anyone. So like there's two more classes. So the final class is carver's choice, and then they carve, and then they'll put it up on social media, and then I'll critique it for them. And really it's just about helping carvers develop. If they have questions about tools, I talk about it. I'm just trying to be an open book. Yeah, I've carved lions, Gavin, for sure. There's some ones from the Hope competition. Mountain lions, cougars, beasts, all kinds of crazy stuff. And for this year, yeah, some hater was saying shit about like I carved too many bears. And just so you guys know, whoever is following my page, and thank you if you are, and make sure you follow right now if you don't, and give it a like. I'm doing things in order, and I'm just trying to make a video for you guys to keep content flowing. But as most of you know, people like bears, eagles, owls. But I'm doing a Wicked Wizard first carving back. Them Echo 251s and some machines. Yeah, they're awesome. I love them. The 2511 is going to be the best saw. Comes out in the spring in North America. And so pitter-patter, let's get at her. But yeah, so I got a wizard. Then I go ice carving for 2 weeks. And I'm doing, I can't even wait to tell you guys. Fucking stoked. Game of Thrones themed and 160 blocks. So that's like... oh my god. So each block's 300 pounds, times that by 160. Spike, you do the math, because you're a really smart guy. So it's tons of ice. So I'm gonna film that. We'll be up in Fort St. John for that. And then I go and do the Vernon Festival, which is Western themed with 160 blocks. Me, Kevin Lewis, and Douglas Fir. Kevin Lewis actually is starting a YouTube page soon. I'm gonna really pump that once I start, once he starts. He does wicked spirit faces. He's big inspiration to Jordy. A lot of you guys know me from Jordy. And he's big fantasy spirit face, like funky style. Awesome dude. Hopefully he can talk as good as he can carve. And then, yeah, so then in moving into the next year, I've got a crazy installation for a hotel. So it'll be a like repetitious video. And then a 12-foot dragon, a 10-foot raven that's gonna take me a month to carve. Wings out, like, no fucking around. Oh, sorry, I'm gonna get monetized credit taken away for that. Yeah, it's gonna be a massive raven. Take me about a month and a half to do. But that's enough talking. Anyone else have any questions? Quickly, before I gas up and go. Yeah, 10-foot raven, and then Chetwin. Chetwin's happening this year, so I'll be carving that competition, which is gonna be absolutely mental. If Campbell River happens, I might go to it as a judge if they'll have me, but I don't know yet, or maybe even go compete. And then possible Carve and Cross Canada filming the TV show, which will be pretty tricky for me to do YouTube videos, but I'll keep the content coming, but I'll be shooting for like, 4 months if it happens. 3 months, it'll be crazy. But book to August, tons of cool carvings. Pitter patter. Let's get out of here. Sorry, guys. Chitty chatty today because I'm just carving. Okay. Ooh. Should have worn my arm brace. What is the 2511 weigh? I don't know. 4 pounds wet with the bar and chain. Maybe like 6, 7. Okay. Cool. Thanks for watching, guys. Give this a like and subscribe to my page. I hate saying all this stuff, but it's just like what everybody else on YouTube does. So that's what I figure I got to do. Not kilograms, Spike. Pounds. Pounds. This thing is so light. It's like... it's awesome. Awesome. I'm gonna get the head done here, and then I'm gonna move in to getting underneath and doing the legs. The legs are the trickiest part because they're super thin, but when you have 3 points of contact, tail being the majority of the weight, as long as I have 3 points. Yeah, you can see this is all like majorly connected. Then you can really like get thinner on the legs, but I'm not gonna go crazy. Okay. Here we go.
Back in Tupelo in 1935, baby boy rocked the world and rhythm came alive. Here comes the king. We'll be right back.
jumping around. I need to stay focused.
Stay focused. How are you doing? Okay. Tail after. Tail after.
Everything. Makita finger sander, saber tooth flame bit, Dremel 4300, Dremel code bit 4300. And I use Makita 4-inch angle grinder with the small angle grinder for everything. I double these up for strength. I know it's a little bit crazy, but they're safer. Just make sure you get the right backing pad for this thing. That's the most important thing you want to think about. Because if you get too big, it'll blow up and they're pretty painful. I learned the hard way. Did I go wrong to remember was your king? You were my queen, as I remember everything. Holding. Father, the father, the baby is not my daughter, cause baby's a different color. Hey, what's up, Argentina? What's up?
You! Oh, I need a drink. This is water, not 7-Up. That'd be a lot of 7-Up. And another one bites the dust.
see. Still going?
Yeah, cool. Okay, eyeball.
Thank you.
so lonely without you. I know that you're coming to the bedroom where we used to sit and smoke cigarettes, watching you die. Oh, 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 oh.
I've been waiting for you. But you did to save my life. Shit out of it.
mask is sweaty. Sorry, I know that was gross. My wife always yells at me for it.
Okay, clear my area. And we'll blow it out and burn it. Glad that went better than it could have. Okay, so burn, 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 burn.
Hey, Jordy! Where's my fire? Where are you, fire? Son of a gun. And I got it. This is Ghetto Editorial.
Okay, final touches. Where?
16 years to find ya. 1 second to love ya. 7 years to hold ya.
Where did I go wrong?
All the nasty shit. 'Cause I remember everything.
Okay. Oh, that's a little
not painted there.
the father, but baby is not my daughter, cause baby's a different color, but baby I'm not a brother, just too much to swallow. You rip my heart out. Good song.
Is to find you. All right, done. I gotta wait until it dries and then I'll clean the bass up. Whew! It's good. I actually like this side better. Thanks, Spike. Okay, welcome to live chat. Remember, what? Abide by guidelines. Oh, I see. Did I just mess it up? I don't know. There we go. Thanks for watching. Bigfoot video, or... Once I cut his arm and make it smaller, I'm really close to having that edit done. I gotta fix a couple of things, get him buffed up. I'll have that video out maybe tomorrow or the next day. And I'm gonna have a quick lunch here. And then I'm gonna start on this piece. Oh, here's this piece. Big bear, just waiting to go. There we go. Big log, big stick. If anybody has any questions or anything, fire away, I'm looking. So, and then I'm gonna sign off because it's 2:30. Oh, 160 minutes, so I don't know. I like this one. This is one of my better Ravens. Definitely. Burning the paint dries it faster and then puts like a weird coat that I like on it. But I also do it a couple times because it gets penetrates into it. And also if you think back to when I was doing it, how cool that texture looked. How cool it looked when it was done the first time. Like, I really liked it exposing the wood, but it doesn't work for a Raven, but it works for a lot of other stuff. So it's very popular style in like Japan and Europe. Oh, I love that lighting. I'm gonna have to take a picture of it like this later. Yeah, it's good lighting. It's too bad it's my shop is such a pigsty, but what can you do? Yeah, so lots of chainsaw work and pretty balanced overall for eyes. Sorry about that. I gotta call my wife back. So I figured out why my phone freezes. It's when people call. So I gotta try to figure out how to do that. And yeah, thanks guys. Thanks for watching. And what's your favorite carving? My favorite carving is the... this one. And then my next favorite carving will be the one after. No, probably Poseidon's one of my favorites. The one I did for my dad in Chetwynd's one of my favorites. The goblin. If you go on Ryan Cook Carvin on Instagram, ryancook.carvin, or facebook.com/Saw Valley, you'll see lots of them. Yeah, Grim Reaper. Grim Reaper's one of my favorites. I did that for my friend. That was a kind of a, it's a sad, great story, but if you look at that piece, you see the devil trying to climb up, and so what I was saying was my friend, I gotta set it to airplane mode. I gotta just make sure that my Wi-Fi works, and if my wife calls two times, then it's something, so I had to answer it. The Grim Reaper, my friend died. He overdosed on heroin. He was one of my best friends growing up. And, you know, I put the heart in the hand because he was such a good guy. And he just couldn't beat that drug. So, like, the devil was coming to get his due because he was the Grim Reaper. But the Grim Reaper was handing the heart to heaven because, you know, if I can cry. With what a good guy he is, I thought that, you know, it was fitting. He is in heaven and I know it. So yeah, Travis Buckley. Love that dude. Rest in peace, buddy. And, so yeah, that's it. This has been fun. Thank you guys for watching, for everyone who stuck it out the whole time. I'll do more live streams. I'm not going to live stream this cause I honestly just have to focus on doing the piece, but I will have it out for Christmas. This hopefully will be a big one, like the elk. And so yeah, it's gonna be eagle wings up, mama bear, baby bear climbing tree, and salmon swimming around the base. So it's gonna be pretty full on. And I'll be carving till the 22nd, deliver 23rd. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. See you later. You know it, Marcello.